The company's friendly rivalry has turned a bit sour as Star Comics writer Brian Michael Bendis defects, and Warner's insiders fret about its A-list superhero team-up being overshadowed by Disney's B-character in Thor, Ragnarok. The November slugfest between Marvel Studios Thor, Ragnarok and Warner Bros. DC film Justice League is bigger than just the box office. It's a fight for comic supremacy. On the Warner's DC side, the mood is about as jovial as a party thrown by the Joker. While Ragnarok is just the latest in a string of film hits for the Kevin Feige-led Marvel Studios, Warner Bros. Is desperately hoping to continue the momentum from its first big success, this summer's Wonder Woman, $821 million worldwide. If a B-character from Marvel shutdowns and outperforms the A-team from DC, that's an embarrassment, a Justice League insider tells The Hollywood Reporter, adding, it's going to be a stressful weekend for some Warner's execs. For Warner Bros., Justice League is tracking for a $110 million debut, dramatically behind the massive $166 million Batman v Superman grossed in March 2016. And inside Warner's, expectations are muted for Justice League, which has received very mixed reviews from top critics. The film's tumultuous shoot included Zack Snyder exiting following a family tragedy and Joss Whedon stepping in to oversee extensive reshoots that cost millions. Sources say the studio has higher hopes for the solo movie Aquaman, which hits theaters December 21, 2018. Meanwhile, on November 7, days after Ragnarok opened to $122.7 million in the U.S., DC Comics lured superstar Brian Michael Bendis away from Marvel, where he had spent the past 17 years penning bestsellers including Ultimate Spider-Man and The Avengers, which helped inspire multiple films and TV shows. Bendis inked a multifaceted deal that sources say could give him input on Warner Bros. Growing stable of DC films. While Marvel put on a professional face, calling Bendis a great partner and appreciating his creativity and professionalism, several sources tell THR that staffers were taken by surprise at the poaching move. He was one of the people I thought would never leave, says author Reed Tucker, whose book Slugfest chronicles the heated rivalry between the two comic companies. I was shocked. Friendly rivalry has been in the company's DNA since the 1960s, when Marvel's Stan Lee would insert jabs at DC into his comics, characterizing the competitor as square, and Marvel as the hip underdogs. DC would respond by ribbing Lee as a grandstanding self-promoter.